Hi guys, and welcome to today's tutorial. Today's video is about pixel stretch, in which we're going to do some magic with this image and make it look like this. So let's get started. Now the first thing we need to do is replace the background with black for a nice effect. And to do that, let's just go to Select and hit Subject. You'll find the girl who's the subject of the image getting perfectly selected by Photoshop. So just hit the Add Vector Mask button at the bottom of the Layers panel and you will have isolated the subject. Time to add the black background. So let's click the Create New Fill or Adjustment Layer button at the bottom of the Layers panel and select the Solid Color option. From the color picker, if black is not already selected, just left click and drag to the extreme bottom left corner to select black and hit OK. Since our image is hidden by this black background, let's drag this layer to the bottom to reveal the image. Wow, the image is looking so 3D-ish, something I didn't intend to do. Anyway, hold Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and select both the layers. And then right-click and select the Merge Layers option to merge both the layers. Now we need to make a copy of this layer, so let's drag it to the small plus button at the bottom of the Layers panel to duplicate it. You can even use the shortcut Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC to achieve that. Have the top layer selected and select the Single Column Marquee tool. This tool lets you create a 1 pixel wide horizontal or vertical selection. I'm going to click just once, somewhere on the center of the image, and you'll be able to clearly see a perforated line being created. Hit Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC to duplicate this selection, at which point you shall find another layer being created with just that selection. It's time to activate the free transform mode, and to do that, hit Command T on a Mac or Control T on a PC. And you shall find your selection with handles on both the corners and one right at the center. Click the one at the center and drag it to the extreme right. And then hit the tick on top to register the stretch. Let's rename this layer right side. Now we need another stretch for the left side as well. So let's go back to the layer in the middle. If the Single Column Marquee tool is not selected already, just select it from the toolbox and then click once anywhere to the left side of the image. I'm going to click here because it's going to give me the whole hair to pull the pixels from. Let's hit Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC to duplicate this selection. And you shall find another layer being created right above this layer. Let's rename this new layer Left side. Now let's hit Command T on a Mac or Control T on a PC for the free transform and stretch this side of the image as well. Now the next step is optional, so you may want to do it or you may skip it, whatever makes you happy. I'm going to do it, so holding Command on a Mac or Control on a PC, select the top two layers and change their blending mode to Lighten. Now, with the left side layer selected, hit the Add a Vector Mask button at the bottom of the Layers panel to create a mask. Similarly, create a mask for the right side layer as well. Let's go back to the original layer, which is the third one from the top. And then go to Select, and then Subject to make a selection of the subject, which is the girl in our case. Once the selection is made, we're going to start with the right side layer. So let's select the mask of the right side. Ensure that the foreground color is black. And then pick the brush tool. Pick the soft round brush. And brush the right side of the image to get the details back. Ensure to not leave any detail unbrushed. Similarly, select the mask of the left side layer and brush the left side of the image to get the details back. You'll find how 3D-ish the image looks with the stretched pixels on both sides of the image. So guys, That's how you pixel stretch in Photoshop. All right, guys, that concludes our session today. Hope you've learned something new and have enjoyed this tutorial. So do like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Until we meet again, goodbye, and thanks for watching.